Good morning and welcome to sunny New Jersey. We're out in the Pine Barrens here, working on our latest project. We have a little outdoor shower going with 8 people living in our house. Didn't want to put too much pressure on our septic system, so decided to try to do this for as little money as possible, not running any electric or plumbing or having a pressure tank involved. We looked on YouTube for quite a while to try to get some ideas of how to put one of these together, and we got some general ideas, but nothing really specific on how to actually make it work. So we thought we'd share with you our experiences and make it as simple as possible for you to do the same. Altogether, we spent about $60 or $70 just on 4 pieces of pressure-treated 4x4 for the main supports of the back section of that shower. We had to get one piece for the plumbing, the handle that actually turns the water on and off, and the netting, the mosquito netting up top on that barrel, just to keep the bugs out. Everything else was free to us, or we had laying around anyway. So I'll walk you through the different components. First over here, the bench we just found on the side of the road, painted that up just kind of like a place to put your stuff for next person in line to wait for their shower. The decking we found in the woods, Bunzer Trex decking that we'd used as walkways in our garden. Just cut that down to size after everything else was built. That was like the last thing we did. The bamboo was donated by my brother and sister-in-law that live not that far away. They have quite the bamboo grove surrounding their property, and they were nice enough to let us cut some down and cut it to size. And then my wife was able to kind of weave it together with fishing line. It kind of rolled up into a mat, and then when we were ready, we just propped it up to the height we wanted and laid it in place, and then nailed and put liquid nails on it to hold it. So that's pretty solid now, and then it was just a matter of filling in all the gaps to make it as non-see-through as possible. And that extends all the way to the back here in the shed. Then we have the shower curtain inside. I'll show you. It's also something we just happen to have laying around, using an old canopy bar. Just put it to the height we needed and just slide it into place, and you got complete privacy from that side of the house. A little bench to put your stuff down, get changed afterwards, random hooks and knobs to hang towels on and let them dry off, little place to put the shampoo, conditioner, body wash, and then the actual plumbing assembly itself. We had the cap inside the 50-gallon drum. The buttress cap had a 3/4 inch, I believe, spot where we were able to put a cap in and then reduce it down to the 1/2 inch we needed for the shower head we picked. We had a bunch of shower heads laying around, and we were actually a little bit worried about the water pressure because we kept seeing that you needed quite the distance between the water source and the actual drain to build up the pressure and have it come out at a pretty good speed. This is only about 8 to 12 inches from the actual barrel, but we were pleasantly surprised when we hooked it up. It's almost as good as it is inside, maybe even a little bit better. Temperature right now, a little on the chilly side, it's around 80 degrees here in New Jersey. But when we had those 90, 100 degree days, I was coming out here every day taking multiple showers. So we might look at putting something in the future if we can get it inexpensively or free, some kind of solar system, because again, we don't really want to run electric all the way out here. We don't have to. Made this little rod with a hook and a flat bar on it to help the kids be able to reach that chain, pull it down, and then push the lever back up. When they're using the shower, they got the hang of that pretty quick. And then up here, we have a hose that goes up to the top of the barrel. I'll try to climb up there so you can see it better. That serves as both our overflow spout and our filling system when it isn't raining. Right now we have it so that the garbage can lid, which we painted and heats up the water pretty well up top, secures everything, keeps everything in, and keeps all the other stuff we don't want out. But when it's not raining, we can fill it up via that hose right there, and then everything's secured with that strap. Even painted the deck black to see if that would help warm things up a little bit more. So it's been pretty good for us so far. You can also see atop the bamboo, tried to cut them everything off to a flat level where water wouldn't get inside and start to rot or decay it even faster. So I filled it up with caulk as best I could. So far so good on this. Been enjoying taking showers out here after working outside. And again, almost completely free to us. Thanks for joining us. I will show you the speeded up footage of how this all went together.
The glory of you.